Hello, fellow Gores. I just wanted to talk to you about some recent game news. I'm sure you have all heard that the bad news with Nintendo, Satoru Iwata, passed, which is unfortunate. And I know this video is a little late for this, but I wanted to do kind of a tribute video. When I first heard about this, I was like shocked. I was like, whoa. For those of you who aren't really sure, he was the past, most recent president of Nintendo, and at first I was like, okay, that's kind of a shock, you know, that sucks, whatever. It didn't really think too much of it, and until today, when I was really thinking, you know, I was like, oh, you know, I was doing a little more research. You'll have to excuse my laptop, I had some things here I just wanted to jot down to make sure I talked about everything I wanted to talk to you about, but I just started thinking about all the Nintendo stuff I played and how much of an impact he really had on Nintendo without even thinking about it. You know, because at first you're just like, okay, president, he didn't do anything, whatever, you know, which is stupid, I know, but I don't really follow up too much with Nintendo. I mean, I play the stuff when it comes out and stuff, you know, I watch some stuff, but I didn't know that much about him. I mean, I knew quite a bit about him, you know, how he started with Nintendo and all that, so it was kind of a big deal. He was with Nintendo since, like, the beginning, almost, but, like, it just didn't seem to bother me at first, and I started thinking about all the stuff that I played. But just a little background on him. He was 55 when he died. He was born in 1959. I had to double check that. I couldn't remember. 1959 to 2015, this past Saturday. Was dealing with a lot of heart stuff, I believe. I know it was cancer, that he just couldn't win, which is too bad because, a few years ago, or not too long ago anyway, he had mentioned on Twitter and stuff that he was, you know, getting better and doing well, and then all of a sudden, bam, he died, which sucked. But he really wasn't originally the president. Like, he didn't just come into it. He had worked at a place called, I'm sorry, I keep referencing this just because I want to make sure I get it out right, HAL Laboratory. H-A-L, I don't know what that is. I just want to be able to kind of give you guys a good background. So he worked at HAL Laboratory, and they kind of worked with Nintendo on the favicon, which is family computer. I don't have that down. I think it's family computer. Favicon was family computer, maybe, I don't know, which in the U.S. was Nintendo Entertainment Center. NES, or Nintendo Entertainment System, I'm sorry. Man, I can't talk. So they worked on the NES kind of together, and then eventually he started working for Nintendo, as a programmer. And he kind of just eventually worked his way up, but he worked as a programmer when he was like around 2021, and he worked on like big deal stuff that really got the industry kicked off, like, Earthbound, Balloon Fight, Kirby was a big one, stuff like that in the early days. Then he eventually got promoted to director, one of the directors, director in 2000, 2002, became president. So he's been president since 2002, and he is actually the only non-founding family member, to be president, so that was kind of cool. So, you know, he's been a big deal with Nintendo since forever. I mean, he's been there almost the whole time. But I was thinking about this earlier today, and I was sitting there, and I was like, Nintendo, like, I grew up with a PS1. My first system was a PlayStation 1. My first three games, which I remember, I had Soul Blade, Air Combat, and Crash Bandicoot 2. Those were my first three games for it, and they were awesome. And Sony House, basically. PS1, PS2, PS3, all of that, 360s eventually, stuff like that. I didn't have Sega or Nintendo. My first thing was PS1, which sounds weird. I had this one friend, his name was Max, and I'd go to his house all the time. We'd play old Nintendo stuff, because he had Super Nintendo, and he didn't have an NES. He had Super Nintendo and 64. You know, he had all the Nintendo stuff. And I remember when I was really little, we'd sit in his basement on the Super Nintendo playing Mega Man all the time, like all the different Mega Mans and Mario Kart and stuff on 64. And we would play Super Smash Brothers, which was a big deal back then. That was a great game. So all these games, you know, he was there, like, this whole time. And, like, once you start thinking about it, it's crazy. But, and then I remember another thing I was thinking about that really stuck out to me in relation to him. The DS, the original, the very first DS, I remember sitting there at home watching, my parents were watching the news or something, and they called me into the room, they're like, oh, check out this new system, whatever, because they knew I'd be into it, because I love video games, and I'm watching the TV, and they're showing this thing that folds, and it's got a touchscreen, and it was this big deal, and I was like, how is this even possible? Like, I couldn't even believe this. I was like, a touchscreen handheld, this is crazy, and that was totally his idea. Satoru, it was his idea completely from, the main idea was all his, and that's just a great idea. I mean, the DS, hands down, is one of Nintendo's best, best consoles. It's the best handheld. It's doing better than, like, the Wii or Wii U did, combined, I believe. The DS is a great system, and it's, like, Nintendo's main thing, the thing they're really pushing, yeah, he was responsible for other things, of course, like the whole deal with Dina in the mobile games. That was him closing that deal. I mean, there's a lot of other people involved in all this stuff, of course, but, like, focusing on him. I mean, he worked on the GameCube, the Wii U, all of that. And he came in at a time when he became president. Nintendo wasn't doing well. They were kind of going downhill a little bit. He came in and kind of picked them up, aside from the Wii U. That just had trouble, but he found a way to market the Wii, the first Wii, in such a way that everybody had to have one. Like, I couldn't name one person back then that didn't want one. Everybody wanted one. Motion gaming for the first time. It was this huge deal, you know, playing tennis with a stick and boxing, and Wii Sports with the Wii was such a big deal, and I remember everybody just wanting one so bad. And, you know, he did a damn good job coming in and doing that. He really made it so everybody wanted it. He also worked on the GameCube, the Wii U, of course, closing the deal with Dina, stuff like that. Let's see, what else do I have here? I just want to make sure I'm not missing anything, because I had a lot I wanted to talk about. Actually, I think I talked about pretty much everything. Oh, fun fact, I missed this earlier. His first game he ever published, that was ever published, was Super Billiards. I don't know what it was for, I just read that. I was doing some back research, I just want to make sure I got my facts straight. Most of this I knew, but I just want to make sure I was giving it to you the right way so it didn't look like an idiot. Although I'm pretty sure I already messed some stuff up. But I wanted to quote him. He's got two quotes that are really great quotes. And they're both from the Game Developers Conference speech he gave in 2005. And I'm sure you know this first one. The first quote I want to tell you is, on my business card, I am a corporate president. In my mind, I am a game developer. But in my heart, I am a gamer. And that quote is that quote meant probably more to me than I've seen in quotes. As some of you know, I have my own game development company just started, you know, trying to get on it. So I'm the founder of this company. I'm also a game developer, but at heart, I love games. So this really related to me. And it's a great quote. It really is. And this next quote I really liked as well, this kind of relates to the gamer thing, and this quote is, even if we come from different sides of the world, speak different languages, even if we eat too many chips or rice balls, even if we have different tastes in games, every one of us here today is identical in the most important way. Each one of us has the heart of a gamer, which is a great quote, because it's basically saying, it doesn't matter who you are, I'm getting all corny here, which is terrible. I hate corny stuff. But, like, everybody, you know, doesn't matter what console you think is better, you know. PS4 is better. Xbox One is better. Just shut up. We're all gamers. Who cares? You know, everything's subjective. So, if you don't like somebody someone else doesn't like, who cares? I mean, I don't consider myself a hardcore Nintendo fan until I really thought about it today. Like, I'm going to show you here in a minute my Nintendo collection. I have more Nintendo stuff than anything else, aside from my Xbox One game collection, which I'm sure you've seen. But I've been kind of been trying to collect old stuff, and I'm just starting, but I'm doing good. But most of it, once I looked at it, most of it's Nintendo. At least all of the, like, valuable, cool stuff is. The more rare stuff. I mean, I have a lot of stuff, but I'm going to go through my Nintendo stuff next, kind of as, like, a tribute thing. And then at the end, I'm going to do a whole another thing, maybe. I might add some more info in there and kind of show some pictures and cool stuff from Nintendo and do something. I don't know. You guys will know. Just watch. I'm going to show you my collection next, so I'll see you guys in a minute. Sorry if the video quality's bad. In this next part, I'm going to be holding the camera myself. But, yeah, I'll see you in a minute. So I'm going to show you my Nintendo stuff. Sorry if you can't really see me too much. I can't really see what I'm aiming at. But I'm just going to go through my Nintendo stuff, kind of talk about some stuff, what means the most to me, stuff like that. Sorry, my room's kind of a mess right now. I need to get better set up for my game stuff because it's pretty rough. I'm running out of room. But yeah, I got clothes everywhere and everything, so bear with me. And this kind of area is a mess too. But let's start right here. Of course, you know what this is? The NES. And it's got the NES Advantage stick, which is really cool. This console, of course, everybody knows what this is. I used to play this at the doctor's office, waiting in the waiting room. I remember that really well, playing Duck Hunt and Super Mario on that one cartridge. I'll show you that in a bit. I've got that, actually. So this console was like the first thing I ever played at the doctor's office. Really cool. And then we'll go right over here and Super Nintendo. I was talking about this one earlier, about how I used to play it with my friend, and we'd play Mega Man and all that good stuff. Really good console. Still good. Still holds up, especially Super Mario World, which is fantastic. I also have the Super Scope sensor, but I don't have a Super Scope. I know that's weird, but it came with it. And then, let's see, I'm trying to go in order of date, but I think I messed up already. Original Game Boy that I custom painted, which I'll be giving away at some point. Still works, of course. And you gotta love this noise. There's no game in it. Gotta love that noise. Here's the back. It works, obviously. I'll be giving that away at some point. But original Game Boy, I never owned one of the fat ones. I owned the Pocket, Color, Advanced, you know, all of those, SP. Never owned a Micro, but my friend had one of these, and I always thought it was really cool. The big one I always thought was really cool. I had the blue Pocket. My brother had the gray Pocket. My brother got one first, and I remember playing the first games he got, and I remember this. He got the first three games he got. God, I was so young. I don't even think I was in school yet. I have a really good memory, if you can tell. But yeah, I must have been like four. But I must have been younger than that. Jesus, how do I remember this? I remember buying it. We were at Sears. My mom was holding me. And my brother got the gray one, and he got Mario Brothers, like the first Super Mario Land, Ninja Gaiden, and Wheel of Fortune. I remember those were the three games he got, and we had Pockets, so that was, this one's kind of cool to have. And then we'll go to the N64, which I actually have two of. I have the grape one here with the blue controller. I don't know if you can really see it too well. But it's the grape N64 with the blue controller. Now, this one definitely stands out. I mean, I know that I talked about the Super Nintendo a lot earlier with Mega Man and stuff, but I remember spending hours playing Mario Kart and just all of that, like, good stuff. Mario Kart, Mario Party, Super Smash Brothers, Pokemon Snap. Man, so many good games on this that I played. And I never owned any of these until, like, now. I played them at friends' houses because they all had Nintendo stuff. And, I mean, there's the PS1 that I was talking about earlier, but we're keeping this all Nintendo for the most part. So, yeah, I remember playing that one a lot. That was so much fun. And I always wish I had these. Like, I was like, oh, they're so cool. But I also loved my PlayStation. But we just never liked, or, well, I liked it. My brother was not a huge fan of Nintendo, so we got, like, PlayStation because we both liked them. Because my parents would buy them for both of us. But let's go up here And we will go over here to the closet. And, sorry. First thing I will show you is the N64 complete in box. Really glad that I have this just because the console was so good. And just, it means, like, that console has a lot of good memories. That's why I'm doing this video. I really wanted to share with you some of my Nintendo stories and stuff. So we're going to go through the rest of my Nintendo stuff, and I'll talk to you about it, how I got it, why, and all that good stuff. So right here, real quick, Mario is missing. This was a really old PC game, as you can tell. Really old graphics, side-scroller. You play as Luigi, which was really cool. I never actually played this game. I got this because I remember hearing about this game. Found it at a store really cheap, and I had to get it because it was really cool. I have Game Boy, of course, complete in box. This is just a regular. This isn't the custom painted one. This is just a complete in box. Another gray one. Again, great console. Awesome console. Let me put that down there. Get that out of the way. Alright. Mario Paint. Focus, camera. Come on, camera. There we go. So Mario Paint. This is complete with the mouse and mouse pad and everything. Great condition. Never really played this. It's just a paint simulator thing. But it has Mario on the box, and it's really cool anyway. I really wanted to do this. I'm excited I'm doing this video, because it's fun to kind of give, a tribute to him, and kind of in memory of showing my collection and everything. So it's kind of exciting. Here's the Wii 25th Anniversary Super Mario All-Stars, which is brand new. It has basically a collection of all the old games, like Super Mario Brothers and Mario Brothers 2, Mario Brothers 3, the Lost Levels. And then it's got, history, soundtrack CD, and some other stuff. The only thing that sucks is the tape. I bought this at, a thrift shop thing. Like, my friend owns a video store, or a video game store. See, the tape there, a customer opened it thinking it was just store tape, but the discs inside are brand new and wrapped. It's just kind of annoying that they're like that, that a customer opened it like that. Gotta get this out of the way. Super Game Boy, which is also complete in box. This allowed you to play Game Boy games on your Super Nintendo. Really cool adapter. I used it to test it. Actually, I think it's missing the inserts. I'm going to have to get a different one. Maybe I'll give this one away. I'm really big into having a very complete. I don't think this is complete because I can hear it moving around. I wonder why I bought it if it wasn't complete. But anyway, we're going to move on. It's a brand new copy of F-Zeros for Super Nintendo, but it's the best of, so it's not really that rare. But it's still really cool. Never really played F-Zero, but I was glad I found this brand new, and I grabbed it. We're going to go up here. So, I have Zelda 2, The Adventure of Link, which is the gold cart complete, which is really cool. I have Duck Hunt complete in box, Mario Brothers complete in box, and then I have the Mario Duck Hunt cartridge that I was talking about earlier that I used to play at the doctor's waiting room. And I got this because that way I can play on one without ruining the other in the box. And then WrestleMania, which I got for free. I don't have a lot of cartridges. And then a regular Mario Paint, again, so I can use it without opening the box. Not that I really am ever going to. And then my N64 collection, which is very small, but I like it a lot because I've got a lot of key games here. So I have A Bug's Life, Conker's Bad Fur Day, which is one of the important ones here, Diddy Kong Racing, Of course, Donkey Kong 64, yellow cartridge, so you could tell. GoldenEye, very important game. That was a big deal. Paperboy, again, big deal. Love Paperboy. Mario Kart, which is fantastic. Everyone knows that. Mario Party 2, which again is fantastic. Super Smash Bros., which is even more fantastic. And then one of my favorite games as a kid, Tony Hawk, Pro Skater, which I own for pretty much every console, WrestleMania 2000. So those are my N64 games. I also have some here. I have Command & Conquer, Complete in Box, World Is Not Enough, Complete in Box, and Tony Hawk's Pro Skater, Complete in Box. We're going to zip back up here. I got a Game Boy Color Yellow, Complete in Box, which is actually like in mint condition. Really like the color. I need to get some... I would like to get every color. I think that would be really neat to have them all displayed. And I have a Game Boy Advance, which is complete in box. I'm going to try and get every Game Boy, even every color, just because I love Game Boy so much. And Game Boy Camera, also complete in box, great condition. Never really used the Game Boy Camera, but when I was a kid, I always wish I had the Game Boy Camera and the Game Boy Printer. I always thought it'd be so cool, so I had to get one, just for nostalgia reasons of remembering the good old days. Alright, now we're going to zip on down to... Oh, those are Atari. Game Boy games, which I don't have a lot of. Ooh, I got to put that back up top. Okay. Donkey Kong Land. Important game to have. I'm letting this focus, hopefully. Come on, focus. I don't know why it does this every time. Focus. There. So I have Donkey Kong Land. Sorry about that. Getting used to this new camera. Kirby's Dream Land. Very great game. Uno. And then some Harvest Moons. Nothing great here. And then some other random... Top Pin Alley, and a poker game, and then World Tour Poker, which is brand new. That's for Advanced. These, actually, all these here are Advanced. That's a Game Boy Color, and then the other two are Game Boy. I can't get those to stay up now. Shit. Memory cards falling everywhere. I'll leave them there for now. And then we come down to here. I got a couple GameCube games. Again, I gotta remind you that I just started collecting again. I don't have a lot of Nintendo stuff, but I wanted to share what I have. So I have 1080 Avalanche, which I really liked when I was a kid. Agent Under Fire, which is another Bond game. Battalion Wars, Namco Museum. Soul Calibur 2, which is fantastic because it had Link. And then X-Men Legends 2, which was really good. And then I'll grab my Wii games from down here. It's kind of a pain to get to, so... I have a Wario Land Shake It. This one's kind of cool. I've never seen this in person. I grabbed it. It's Tatsunoko versus Capcom Ultimate Ace Stars. I never played this, but I found it, and I was like, that's really cool. Like, look, it even has Frank West, which is sweet. Really cool looking game, so I grabbed it. And then, of course, Super Smash Bros. Brawl. I still need to get Melee for GameCube. But, yeah, great game. Fantastic game. I remember playing that a lot on the Wii. Super Paper Mario, of course. Gotta have that. That was a good game. Super Mario Galaxy, which is also a really good game. I really like that. Rampage. Good arcade game. I haven't played the Wii one. I just have it. Mario Super Sluggers, which I never played, but it's Mario. And Mario Kart Wii with the Wii Wheel. And I'm trying to think. And then I just have a bunch of N64 controllers and stuff. Oop, my lens cap. Bunch of N64 controllers and stuff. Don't really have too much else yet, but I just kind of wanted to share that stuff with you guys. in hope that possibly put you back on here. I just kind of wanted to share with you guys. I got one more thing. I have a broken green Game Boy Color, which I'm trying to fix. It's currently taken apart. Another Game Boy Advance. I'm trying to fix these. I got them super cheap. It was like $13 for both of these on eBay. I was like, yeah, I can probably fix them. I do a lot of refurbishing. So that's pretty much all my Nintendo stuff. Can't really think of anything else as of now. I want to get more, of course. I want to get even more now. You know, I feel like I need to get a lot more of that stuff. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you guys have any cool stories or want to say anything, go for it in the comments. That'll be awesome. I'm going to try and reply to everybody. Tell me your stories, your favorite game, your favorite Nintendo game, whatever. I hope you guys enjoyed this, and I will talk to you guys later. Have a great day. I knew I would forget something. It's nothing major, but it's still cool. Donkey Kong 64 Strategy Guide. I just had to share that. Okay, goodbye.
Us now, we're not alone. Before you know it, your cup's overflown. You measure no one that I've ever known, and it's quite alright. And goodbye for now. Just look up to the stars and believe who you are, 'cause it's quite alright. And so long, goodbye. We always knew that it'd come to this. It's times like these I forget what I miss. Matters of heart are hard to address, especially when yours is full of emptiness. And it's quite alright. And goodbye for now. Just look up to the stars and believe who you are, 'cause it's quite alright. And so long, goodbye. Time passes by, direction unknown. You've left us now, but we're not alone. Before you know it, your cup's overflown. You measure no one that I've ever known, and it's quite alright. And goodbye for now. Just look up to the stars and believe who you are, 'cause it's quite alright. And so long.